In this video, we're going to test ChatGPT from asking it to write some basic formulas all the way to creating full-on code to automate tasks using macros. Let's get into it. So here's the Excel file that we'll be working with, which you can download for free in the video description. And as you can see, we have this database here with the brands and how much we sell of each. And specifically, we want to find out all of the unique brands, so all of the unique ones that we have in column E. And the instructions to give to ChatGPT are going to be the following. On Excel, use a formula to find each unique value from cell E3 to E251, which is basically this whole column area over here. So for this, we're just going to copy the instructions, so Control C, and then we'll go to ChatGPT. And in here, in case you don't know what this is basically a free tool that you can use. You just need to sign up for it. And using artificial intelligence, it's able to generate answers to any questions that you might have in text format. So let's give it a try here. We're just gonna Control V to paste it, hit enter, and just wait for it to generate here. So let's take a look at the answer it's generated for us here. And it's proposing we use the unique formula, which is probably the same one that I would have used. And more specifically, it also gives you the cell reference that you're referring to. So from here, all we would need to do is actually just copy it. So just Control C there. And you'll notice down below that it also offers you another alternative if you want, but we're happy with this first one as it's a lot simpler. From here, we're just gonna go over back to the Excel file and just Control V to paste it. And you can see that it's able to find all of the different brands that we had from this data set. One thing to keep in mind here is that ChatGPT doesn't always generate the same answer. Even if you type in the exact same things as me, you might get a different formula or a different type of text as well. You're probably thinking, Kenji, this is such an easy example, but don't worry, we'll get into some harder stuff now. And over here, you can see that we have this balance sheet, and you don't necessarily need to know anything about this, just that these figures here, so these ones in row 9, should be equal to these ones in row 21. So to do that, we'll check over here, we'll make a check that basically says that, and here you can see the instructions, if C9 matches this figure over here, then the check should just say okay. And if not, it should give us an error sign just to make sure. So under the instructions here, let's copy these by hitting Control C again. We'll go to the chat and again, we'll paste it over here and hit enter and wait for it to generate. Let's take a look at the answer that it's written over here. As you can see, it's suggesting the if formula and this is the full syntax that it wants. So if C9 equals C21, okay. And if not, show error. That seems to make sense. It also shows another alternative using conditional formatting here, but we're happy with just this. So we'll copy it, Control C, and let's paste it over here. So let's say we paste it down where the check is, so Control V. And you can see that it's showing okay, meaning that these two are matching indeed. If I change this, say I put a 5 here, it should give me an error as that seems to be the case. From there, we can also copy and just drag it along and paste it there like so. They should all be okay if they are matching. So that seems to make sense there. Now, what if we give it some harder stuff that's not a formula that it can just type up? For example, what if we want a drop-down list? So let's take a look by going to Control Page Down here. You can see that we have the customer name on one side, and specifically we want to create a drop-down list with the values on cell C3 to C11. So basically with all of these here, we just wanna create a drop-down over here. So let's copy the instructions, Control C, and again, we'll go back to ChatGPT and just paste it over here and hit enter. So here it's suggesting that we use the data validation feature. And here's all the steps that it's asking us to do. Now, this is probably easier done with a video demo or some kind of a tutorial, as it's not that easy to follow these set of steps. But regardless, we'll take a screenshot of them and try to reference them as we do it over in Excel. So first, we need to go where we want the dropdown to appear, which in this case, it's over here under H3. Then we need to go under data validation, which in case you don't know where it is, it's probably quite difficult to find, but it's basically this area over here. So just click on that. And then in this scenario, we want to have a list. So let's click on list there. And the source, this is where we want the list to be coming out from. So in this case, it's gonna be generated based on all of the first names that we've got over here, because that's the C3 to C11 basically. Then we're just gonna hit okay. And just like that, you should be able to have a dropdown. As you can see in this scenario, it's not all that useful to use ChatGPT. That's typically the case with anything that requires some visuals or some complex financial modeling and things like that. That's where learning Excel properly is probably recommended. And speaking of learning Excel properly, if that's something of interest to you, you can consider checking out our Excel for Business and Finance course, where we teach everything we know about Excel. And what makes this course different is that it's all applied to the real world. While we still cover the theoretical lessons like formatting, formulas, and charts, we also offer case studies that simulate the type of work you might be assigned in your day-to-day, ranging from financial modeling to cleaning a dataset and presenting some visual insights. And if you get stuck along the way, you can easily ask us questions in the discussions forum. We also offer several other courses, including PowerPoint, finance and valuation, and more. So if you're interested in checking it out, you can go to a link in the description below. All right, back to the video. Let's now go for something even more ambitious on ChatGPT, which is recording a macro. And in case you don't know, a macro is basically recording a set of steps so that you can automate them for future use. So over here, if you go to control page down, you can see in example 4, and the first thing we're gonna need to do is to save the file as a macro-enabled workbook. For this, just go to F12. That's where the Save As pop-up should show up. So like I mentioned, instead of saving like an Excel workbook, we gotta click on that and go to Excel macro-enabled workbook, as we're gonna just record a macro in here. So we'll hit Save there. And let's look at the data set over here. We basically have the weekly sales by country and by day here. And we want a set of different things. So first, we're gonna wanna sum the weekly total. So it's all of these figures here, we're gonna wanna sum them. Same, we're gonna wanna average just below that. And then for the highest day, as you can see the instructions here, we want the maximum, so which one's the highest day. But we want to return the matching value, meaning that we actually wanna see the day, not the actual number. And then the last one, to test a bit of formatting, we're saying to highlight all of these three cells in orange. So it's really quite a few set of steps. So let's try see if ChatGPT can do this for us. So we'll copy all of these, Control Shift down, Control C, and let's head over to ChatGPT. We'll paste it down over here and hit Enter and wait for it to load. Let's take a closer look at the answer over here. And it says that you'll need to use Visual Basic for Applications Program Language. Doesn't really give you much of an explanation on what VBA is, but don't worry, we'll get to that later as I'll give you some context. Basically, this is all the code that we're gonna wanna copy and paste. Then towards the bottom, it's gonna give you the instructions on going ahead and opening up the VBA editor and where to paste things, etc. So let's go ahead and give it a try by copying the code here. Just hit copy code. Then we'll go back to Excel. Once on Excel, to open up VBA, it's said to use the Alt F11 key, so let's do that. And you can see that it's opened it up here, but it's not all that clear where you need to actually paste any of this. So this is where I'm just gonna help you out a bit, but basically we need to go to Insert, then we're gonna go to Module, and from here, this is where we wanna paste it. So we're just gonna paste all of the code here. Then once we've done that, we wanna save it. And again, this is not really something that's been explained, but anyhow, we're gonna save it, and then let's just close out of that. And so now, when we look down over here, we gotta go to the Developer tab to run the macro. Then under Macros, we should have it saved. So this is the one that we just saved here under Macro Name, and we're just gonna hit on Run. As you can see over here, we have all this area in orange. Let's go ahead and double click here so we can see it better. So the weekly total, let's see if that's the same amount. We're just gonna go ahead and run that ourselves to test it out. So it's this area here, sum, it's exactly the same. So that seems to be working well. For the average, it's the average formula here, and we'll select it. That seems to be working well as well. And the highest day, it does seem to be that Wednesday. So that's all good. I will say that the cells, what I had in mind was to only have these three in orange and not the ones in between. I feel like that's what I highlighted here with C16, 18, and 20, but maybe it didn't quite catch that part. Let me know in the comments what you think, if this was good enough or it still needs some work. If you feel like ChatGPT still needs some work, I will say that Excel does have a built-in AI feature, which most people don't actually know about. So let's test it out. You can see that we have this data table, And towards the side, we have the analyze data ribbon. So this area, this button is the one that we're gonna wanna click on. So we'll hit click on that. And you can see that it's gonna start to load a lot of different insights. For example, a pretty useful one is the total sales by city. As you can see, that's not something we have right now, but it's probably a useful thing to know. So we would just click on insert pivot chart. From here, under a new sheet, it's gonna load it up for us. One more thing, if we go back, let's suppose that we're not quite liking any of these suggestions, and so we wanna ask it something else. We can actually do that up over here. So for example, let's say we wanna find out how many sales Coca-Cola had. So we'll just type that, how many sales does Coca-Cola have? Hit enter there, and you can see that it's able to calculate all of that using a pivot table. And you just gotta insert it if you wanna have it somewhere. For more on Excel, check out this video over here to learn about macros, or this link over here to check out our course. Hit that like and that subscribe if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.